I'm Cheryl, and I'm here with Fari, and we are glad to be here with you. Thanks for staying with us. We are going to talk about what we just listened to and digest that, ruminate over it. What do you think, Pastor Fari?
Rumination.
Digestion.
Trials.
You were a trainer, so can you relate to the
whole thing? To what Pastor Dave was mentioning
about
trainers?
Yes, he was talking about patience or endurance.
For sure. It's took a while for me to, when I first started, I think I was 12 when I started martial arts and then weight training at 14. And at the age of 14, I was skinny. And it took a long time. At first I was like, oh yeah, it's going to be a quick process of gaining weight and, you know, strength, but it didn't. It took many years. And so I totally agree. And one thing that stands out to me about when we compare faith with muscles and faith muscles, is that actually it takes resistance. We cannot grow without resistance. And it reminded me of astronauts. When they go out in space, they actually have to do exercises because when you remove gravity and there's less resistance, you start losing muscle. You start losing strength. And they actually have to do specific exercises in space in order to stay healthy and strong and have endurance.
That so coincides with James chapter 1,
yeah.
That, you know, count it all joy when you encounter various trials and the testing of your faith produces patience. Yeah. So if we're wondering, how do we do, are watching and you have a rhythm or regular workout routine where there is even some resistance training, how do you do that with your faith? It's the same thing. And it's the testing of your faith that produces patience or endurance. So say, I want to build up my endurance. I want more endurance. Well, then just be ready because there's going to be some testing of your faith.
It's a dangerous prayer. Yeah.
But it's true as much as, and it's work, right? It's work to work out.
It's work to work out.
You don't wake, I'm sure, how many times in your life were you like, yay, I can't wait. Did you have that
usually,
a lot?
I love going to the gym, but
For most people.
But it's true though, when you're going through it, it's difficult, it's hard. Afterwards you get sore, you know, you can barely sit down, you know, those kind of things. If you hit the gym, you kind of know about those things. But afterwards you're like, wow, I'm stronger. At the next session, if you've had enough rest and you've eaten well, you're stronger. And I think that's one of the things I think about even having a proper rhythm is that's why Sabbath is there. Sabbath, having rest. So when we talk about working out and faith, actually rest is also extremely important. So remembering to rest at least once a week, that idea of being God's presence, resting.
Because there are so many similarities to when you do go to the gym. And in the days when I did have a personal trainer, how important it was. And then even to break up the training of what type of, what he had me do at the gym was quite different to keep switching it up. And I think that has so much to do with the testing of our faith. And I really love how Pastor Dave brought that into wisdom and how God usually gives wisdom. And he said, this is from the backside of the desert, which basically means after years of experience, trust me on this. And that's what he was saying, that after seeing this over many, many years, that wisdom comes in bite-sized pieces. He doesn't show us the big picture of everything. And just like you said, I was skinny. It took a long time to actually build up the muscle mass. Yeah. That's what it's like, too, to build up faith muscle mass. It doesn't just happen. And if we think that will happen, we'll fall flat on our face.
That's it. And God doesn't test us beyond what we can handle.
Yeah.
It's like a good coach, a trainer, doesn't give you too much where you're going to break and you're going to get injured. He actually gives us just enough.
Okay. Well, hey, I had a trainer. And let you tell me, is this normal? I need to know this because I've thought about it. Now you're right here. There was one particular machine that he would have me on, and I thought I was at my threshold. And he's like, no, 10 more, you know, and you start counting backwards, you know, 10, 9, 8. It's like, really? And then he would get to zero, and I think he goes, no, 5 more. And I'd be like, you are mean. Like,
yes.
I don't like you right now at all. Like, this, you are not a nice man. And he would do it. But, you know, he did that until I got to the place where I was so focused, I couldn't talk to him. And then he knew I was going to my threshold. And I think that's, is that...
Yeah, no, I that's what trainers do. Yeah. We want to make people cry a little bit, just a little bit. And I think with God, because what we're saying here, even through the message, is that God wants us to lean on him and rely on him, and he will give us the strength. So he doesn't say trials are going to come and you're going to have strength, or you're going to just pull out strength from inside of yourself. And like the culture that says, you know what, it's in you, you just got to tap into it. No. God is the one who gives you the strength. He's the one. So as we put our faith, again, it's a faith that overcomes, is we put our faith in God, he gives us the strength to be able to do what we couldn't otherwise do. We couldn't lift the trial, the thing that's in our way. We couldn't handle it.
That is such a good point. It does remind me of when Coastal Church first begun. Had he jump-started our faith to a different point, let's say even to where we're at today, we would have crashed. We weren't ready. Our faith muscles were not strong enough for it. So he does. He takes us. Part of going from strength to strength, glory to glory, is the testing of our faith. It's the producing of endurance in those steps.
That's so good. And you even see that with all the different people in the scriptures, with Moses. You see that with David. They don't just start thrown into the deep end. And even with Jesus, he came as a baby, and then he grew up and he grew in stature. And
wow.
And so you see that with different people in the scriptures. God doesn't just throw us into the deep end.
Yeah. Wow. I'm not sure we can add anything to that. So I know it's going to be a little shorter. I feel like we're on a little shorter overtime, but that's just so good. I'm not sure I want to jump off of that other than say you really need to read Pastor Dave's blog on Shattered Dreams, because he talks about Joseph in that blog, and he also talks about the importance of bitterness, of having a heart of bitterness or having a hopelessness or just really lethargy is what it is, and then getting to that place where you just might even be fatalistic, where it's like, what's the use? And so that blog is so good. So I encourage you that there is a difference between temptation and trial.
Yeah, that's what Pastor Dave wanted you to talk about.
Okay, so maybe we're not quite done. But there is a difference between trial and temptation. God cannot tempt any man. So he doesn't bring his temptation. Is always towards, it's towards evil. Hey, this is in closing. A trial brings you closer to God. A temptation takes you away from God. A trial requires you to sacrifice your desires. A temptation will feed those desires. Trial focuses on strengthening your values. A temptation will undermine your values. Trial exposes your weaknesses. A temptation exploits your weaknesses. A trial leads to freedom. Temptation leads to slavery. A trial is an obstacle in the road. A temptation is a fork in the road. A trial is the opportunity to do right. A temptation is the enticement to do wrong. A trial strips away the junk in our lives so we're stronger. A temptation leads us to junk and makes us weaker. So there you go. Hey, God bless you guys. Thank you for staying with us.
Love you guys.